I feel like the road runner when he's paddling as fast as he could and he wasn't keeping up. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Christ Our Redeemer Lutheran Church. We're so glad you're here, either here in person or on Facebook. We got such an awesome God, and we're just happy for everybody to be here. We'll start with as we gather. The saints remind us that we are not alone. We have been washed in the blood of the Lamb and brought into the fellowship of all the saints through baptism. We live this new life by faith now, but then we shall see him face to face and know him as we are known by him. When lonely or fearful, the company of the saints encourages us, and their devotion to the Lord inspires us to endure to the end that we might be saved. Whether known well or known only to God, the faithful are not forgotten, and neither will we be. That is such an awesome thing. We were talking about the saints that have gone before us this morning. There's a lot of them from this church. Please stand as we start with our opening hymn.
Temple and eternal punishment, but I am heartily sorry for them and sincerely repent of them. I pray you of your boundless mercy, and for the sake of the holy, innocent, bitter sufferings and death of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to be gracious and merciful to me, a poor sinful being.
Upon this your confession, know that by the power of Jesus' death and resurrection, he forgives you all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
These are the ones coming out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. In you, O Lord, do I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your righteousness, deliver me, for you are my rock and my fortress. And for your name's sake, you lead me and guide me. Into your hand I commit my spirit. You have redeemed me, O Lord, faithful God.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
These are the ones coming out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb.
Have mercy upon us.
mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant us to follow your blessed saints in all virtuous and godly living, that together with them we may come to the unspeakable joys you have prepared for those who love you. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Until we have sealed the servants of our God on our foreheads. And I heard the number of the sealed, 144,000 sealed from every tribe of the sons of Israel. 12 from the tribe of Judah were sealed, 12 from the tribe of Reuben, 12,000 from the tribe of Gad, 12,000 from the tribe of Asher, 12,000 from the tribe of Naphtiah, 12,000 from the tribe of Messiah, 12,000 from the tribe of Simon, 12,000 from the tribe of Levi, 12,000 from the tribe of Issachar, 12,000 from the tribe of Zebulun, 12,000 from the tribe of Joseph, and 12,000 from the tribe of Benjamin were sealed. After this I looked, and behold, a great multitude that no one could number, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes with palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels were standing around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, "Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these clothed in white robes, and from where have they come?" I said to him, "Sir, you know." And he said to me, "These are the ones coming out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore they are before the throne of God and serve him day and night in his temple, and he who sits on the throne will shelter them with his presence. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more, and the sun shall not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb in the midst of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of living water, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. This is the word of the Lord."
Thanks be to God.
Epistle is from John 3, verses 1 through 3. "See what kind of love the Father has given to us, that we should be called children of God, and so we are. The reason why the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now, and what we will be has not yet appeared. But we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, because we shall see him as he is. And everyone who thus hopes in him purifies himself as he is pure. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. Matthew, the 5th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Seeing the crowds, Jesus went up on the mountain, and when he sat down, his disciples came to him. And he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sakes, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when others revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For so they persecuted the prophets who were before you. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated for an excellent.
Grace, mercy, and peace be multiplied unto you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. My dear friends at CORE, today is All Saints Day. It's a day that we celebrate all those who are called saints. And so the sermon title is For All the Saints. We often sing that before all the saints, especially on this occasion. And we set aside and we think about all of those members who are the saints. When the word saint is mentioned, what do you think of most? Well, most often I suspect that we might first think of famous saints. You know, those past towering heroes of the faith who had stories told about them down through the ages and church names after them. All those faithful witnesses to our Lord. St. Paul, St. Peter, St. Timothy, St. Titus. We could go on and on. St. Matthew, St. Mark, St. Luke. And yes, even St. Martin. That's Martin Luther. Or even the Roman Catholic Church recognizes him as a saint. Many of those who were ultimate witnesses, who we can say gave the great sacrifice of giving up their lives in the service of their Lord. Well, they all deserve to be remembered today, and they all deserve to be celebrated. All of those classic saints of old. And God deserves to be thanked for their outstanding lives and inspiring examples. But while we remember such saints today, our primary focus in this All Saints service is going to be on what we might call our more personal saints. You know, those people of God who have had a direct influence on our personal lives individually, recent and up close. this, especially when I was recently packing up our home. We had to move out so we could get some repairs done. So we had to move everything in the house, and as we were doing and packing things up, we began to go through various boxes to see what needed to be tossed and what needed not to be tossed. And it was then that I came upon this photo. Hopefully you can see him. I know that none of you know who he is. But who this man is? Well, he's my great-grandfather. He's from Russia. And he was there, he moved there from Germany as a Russian who would be farming in the land that was given by Queen Catherine at the time. But he truly is a saint. He's a saint, you see, because he had great influence on my life, although I really didn't ever met the man. I just know the stories about him. I most suspect that all of us begin with our own saints, our own parents, perhaps, our grandparents, and other family members who have had significant influence on our lives, people we remember vividly and gracefully. You know, they can be called saints, too. Even those other heroes of the faith that we call saints, they weren't perfect, but they were holy, just like all the other saints that we remember. Those people whose lives reflect the Beatitudes that we heard in the Gospel lesson for today. There could be godparents among that group. They fall into that category. So who are your saints? Among the gifts of God, deserving to be thanked and remembered on this day, like this might also be people like teachers. Do any of them stand out in your memory? And have you ever thanked God for them? From early school days and Sunday school, the grade school and high school, instructors, professors, maybe also counselors and advisors, coaches. Did anybody make a major difference in your life, a major positive difference? Any offer? Whose work particularly inspired you? Speakers, musicians, artists. What about folks who you work with? Employers, employees, fellow workers, customers, clients, students, parents, doctors. Anyone who has particularly helped you along the way in life. Is there anyone in national life who has inspired you? Or in state government, or even local government? And maybe even your neighborhood? Volunteers? Fellow church members? Sometimes we hear the term patron saints. And maybe that is what we're really getting at today, in a way. Who are your patron saints? The one who made a really difference in your lives. Now, all this discussion might lead to another way of thinking in this business of saints. Can you track back in any kind of line of pattern those people in history who were responsible for the message of God's salvation in Christ Jesus being transmitted to you? You see, those people truly fall into the category of saints. That's what got me thinking about my great-grandfather. You see, he was a man of faith as well. And when he came to this country, he practiced that faith as well. As well as his son and his son. They even formed a local Lutheran church that had a day school of over 450 students. I went to that day school. I learned the faith at that church. called St. Paul Lutheran Church. And all because of those saints like my grandfather. One generation back may be easy to trace, parents and pastors and teachers. But in the generations before that, do you even know the names of those saints? Do you know their stories and how they played a role in you having the same faith that you have? How they played such an impact in the fact that your eternity will be with Jesus Christ and with all believers in heaven? Those who labored, those who toiled, those who crossed oceans and then the continents, those who sacrificed, for accident gave their lives so you could learn in freedom the faith that you have now. We're not reaching far back into history this All Saints Day, although we could do that. It's probably another sermon altogether, another celebration, another way to concentrate on all those famous saints of very long ago, the ones who got churches named after them. Yes, they are part of our heritage, without whom we would not be numbered among the saints today. But for today, our concentration is closer to home, closer to now. Who are your personal saints? I'm going to ask you to take some time to think about it. You can do it now. You can even do it as we continue our service. But certainly you can do it later in the day. And if you had to fill a piece of paper with the names or descriptions of those saints, well, what would their names be? Just don't think about that. Give God thanks for them this day. For this is their day as well. A day to thank God for all the saints. Now may this peace of God that passes all understanding keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Amen.
We confess our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended to heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who is saved from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian apostolic church. I acknowledge my baptism and remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the Lord to come. Amen.
In joyful expectation of the resurrection to life eternal, we remember before the Lord our departed family and friends who have gone before us in faith, and all those who are in our hearts and minds this day. The Reverend George Gillette. Jeanette Gillette. Michael Smith. Joyce Ballard Firestone. Van Jean Newman. Phyllis Vickers. Patty Harbin. Gerhard Doro. Helen Decker. Patricia Swartz. Matt Taylor. Let us pray. Almighty God, we remember with thanksgiving those who have loved and served you in your church on earth, and who now rest from their labors. Keep us faithful with all your saints, and bring us at last to the joy of your heavenly kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we offer before you our communion supplications for the well-being of your church throughout the world.
So guide and govern it by your Holy Spirit.
So guide and govern it by your Holy Spirit, that all who profess themselves Christians may be led into the way of truth and hold the faith in unity of spirit, in the bond of peace, and in righteousness of life. Send down upon all ministers of the gospel and upon the congregations committed to their care the healthful spirit of your grace, that they may please you in all things. Behold in mercy all who are in authority over us. Supply them with your blessings that they may be inclined to your will and walk according to your commandments. We humbly ask for your abiding presence in every situation that you would make known your ways among us. Preserve those who travel, satisfy the wants of your creatures, and help those who call upon you in any need,
Christ Jesus, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Now worship God with our tithes and offerings.
Sacrifice of his body and blood on the cross. gathered in the name and in remembrance of Jesus, we beg you, O Lord, to forgive, to renew, and strengthen us with your word and spirit. Grant us to faithfully eat his body and drink his blood as he bids us do in his own testament. Gather us together, we pray, from the ends of the earth to celebrate with all the faithful the marriage feast of the Lamb in his kingdom, which has no end. Graciously receive our prayers. Deliver and preserve us. To you alone, O Father, be all glory, honor, and worship with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And in the same way also, he took the cup after supper. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." As often as we eat this bread and we drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Amen. Come, Lord Jesus.
O Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Son of the Father, and giving us your body and blood to eat and to drink, you lead us to remember and to confess your holy cross and passion, your blessed death, your rest in the tomb, your resurrection from the dead, your ascension into heaven, and your coming for the final judgment. So remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Have mercy upon us, O Lord, as thou art.
blessings, but steadfastly thank and praise you for all your goodness in this life, until with all your saints we praise you eternally in your heavenly kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace.
Amen.
Please be seated for our closing hymn.
Okay, next week we'll be honored. just waiting. Please tell the church we are thankful for their prayers.
And I know there's a couple other people that have some health concerns too, and bring Chris.
Chris, my grandson was in a bad accident 2 days ago. He's in the in the hospital.
ICU.
He had a fractured hip.
We'll keep those in your prayers. I don't know if there was somebody else or.
There's Joe still. Mandy and Terry Chestnut as well. He's going through a hard time.
So we got a lot to pray for, and from we got a lot to be thankful for too, of all these things of either members of this church or in our families too. So.
Two more. Velvet, do you know what's going on Saturday? Because the fall market is Saturday, and now Velvet suddenly is in charge.
Fall market's happening Saturday.
If you signed up to work, what time should they be here?
9-ish? Yeah. Okay. I have not talked to Katie. I was at a conference all last week, so Katie and I got to get together on the same page. But, you know my number, call me. I'd say be here at 9. If you want to help, it's not, I think the vendors is going to start around 10, so they usually show up around 9 to set up. But I think Mike and I will be here maybe Friday, taking up chairs if needed. It may be that we can have it all over there this year and not have to move things around. We don't really know. We have around 9 or 10 vendors. But come out and
shop.
Shop. Support them, because this is it's a free, I mean, how do I say that? It's a fundraiser, and the vendor groups, I mean, that's all their money. We don't, it's nothing out of our cost to the church, so come out and support it.
And unfortunately, Bill, we got put in charge because Baby's work decided to send Katie out of town. Yes, that with you.
Yeah, Katie's going out of town, so it's kind of like, you know, it may sound like we don't know what we're doing, hey, but I guarantee you, after last week, show up. We know what we're doing.
You know, that's one of the things, like, Cassie used to take dance back years ago. And, you know, I really didn't appreciate it, but anyhow, I went, and I learned an appreciation for it, because they do all this practice, and they work, and everything seems kind of set, and then, like, 10 minutes before it happens, this total chaos. Nobody really knows. And then it happens, and it works. And it's just, I was amazed how it's kind of, they're grabbing for stuff at the last minute, and yet they pull it off, and it works wonderful. So anyway.
And we know God's in charge.
That's right. And the Fall Fest, the Trail Retreat last week, I wasn't here, but that was great. It was just a nice turnout. The weather was great, and we're looking to, our goal is to make it all the way around the prayer path. So, and we were over halfway.
We were over halfway.
And, you know, so we're looking for more to come on that as it grows, and we get maybe a little bit more competitive, like best table, best costume, you know, something like that. Just we're looking to grow it.
This mess with the one hand down, because the soccer goal was a hit.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It was a trailer treat, yeah.
Yeah.
They would have won.
They had good costumes, too.
Yeah. They did. And also, this is November Sunday, November month, the birthdays. I have the Velvet, it's the 5th of November. I have Charlie is the 7th. Brett Walker is the 8th. Alan Moen's the 14th. Destiny Harbin's the 18th. And Jay Quinn's the 30th. Did I miss anybody?
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Christian friends.
else, go in peace and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And have a wonderful week.
Amen.